blowing the tail down, da da da. 100 rounds on a grat da da. Real one like a shot da da. She my little vibe, my little ah ah ah. Bad girl don't run from nobody like ah. Rude boy want me touching on his body like yeah. Boy, I feel dead if he ever diss me.
Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Pretty Gal Reese, and you know today you're about to learn everything that you want to know about me. Where you guys are probably like, who is this girl? Who is she? Well, you're about to find out. Okay, so sit back, relax. I have my little smoothie here. Shout out to my husband for making that little protein for his wifey. So I did post on Instagram about 3 times, Q&A, Q&A, Q&A. Some people swiped up and they asked their questions. So I'm about to just answer them for you all. And I'm also about to introduce myself so you know who I am, where I come from, all that good stuff. So first things first, my name is Garice Otar. Otar is spelled O-U-T-A-R. I'm married to Romaine Otar. I am 20. I'll be 21 July 6th. My husband is 21. He'll be 22 September 27th. So he's 1 year older than me and taller than me and goofier than me. Yes, I'm a Cancer, and I don't know if he's a Virgo, Libra. I don't know the signs. Don't come for me. I was born in Jamaica. So was my husband. I came to the States when I was 8. He came to the States when he was 3. We met in high school. We go back to Jamaica often. Like you see the vlog before, we just came from Jamaica not too long ago. I used to go to Jamaica every summer to visit my mom because my mom is still there. I used to live with my dad and my stepmom and my stepsisters and my brother when I first moved to the States. Let's get to the questions. First person said, how did you and your husband meet? We met in high school. We didn't really get along much in high school. He used to annoy me. And I'm not kidding, he used to annoy me. And I didn't see it as he was trying to get my attention. I saw it as this boy really aggravates my soul and I really do not like him. When COVID hit, we finished senior year from home. So I don't even remember how he got my number, but he started texting me and we used to call each other and we just got so close. I'm like, wow, this man really made me happy. So that's basically how we got together. But in high school, like, we didn't really get along much. He used to like do little stuff to take me off and it worked. But yeah, I love him to death. Second question says, what are some things you want to do before you die? Let's see. I want to get closer with God. I'm already close with God, but I want to be the closest I could be to God, you know? Because like without him, nothing is possible. So you can guess, yes, I'm a Christian. What else I want to do before I die? I want to travel the world. I want to see the world. I have to see the world. I really do. I want to be successful. I want to have at least 3 businesses. At least 3 businesses. I want to buy my dream house in either Texas or Georgia because the housing market's, I really like the houses there. I want to have 2 kids. I want to have a boy and a girl. Yeah. And I just want to explore. I want to explore my husband. Yeah. Dream vacation. Oh my goodness. There's so many. There's so many. How can I pick one? Okay. Let's say my husband and I go to the Maldives and we have one of those over the water bungalow with the infinity pool and the ocean right next to it. It's kind of scary, but yes, but yet thrilling. Yeah, so I'll go swimming in the pool and on the ocean. They have these little bicycles in front of your villa and you can ride it if you don't want to take go-karts, but I think I want to take the go-kart because we just wild like that. And I don't know what's the name of those boats that's like it's in the ocean and they have unlimited drinks and stuff. I think they call it don't even quote me on that. But yeah, we would do that while we're on the trip. We would go parasailing, jet skiing. Oh my gosh. I might even try snorkeling. And I don't even love the ocean like that, but like the view, That would be amazing. Yeah. What else? Try new foods on the vacation. Shopping. Y'all, retail therapy is like the only therapy for me. No lie. Okay, what plans do you have for your future? For my future, I plan to open my businesses. Like I said, I plan to be successful, but it's not what I say, it's what God says. Whatever God have for me, that's what we're gonna do. But if I had to choose, or if what I'm gonna work for is having my businesses and having my best friend as a business partner in at least one of my businesses, living the luxury life that I deserve. I feel like I missed out on a lot growing up. And my adult life is trying to make up for everything I felt that I needed growing up. And just living life, enjoying life, loving life. Life is short. What is your favorite and least favorite thing about being a military wife? My least favorite thing has to be when he's deployed. It could be at any moment. God forbid. I'm gonna knock on wood. I don't even know where wood at, but I'm gonna knock on wood. I remember last year around this time, they just randomly took him to Europe. And it was just out of nowhere. Like, I knew the night before he left. And he's gone for a good amount of time. He was gone for 5 months, 6 months. I don't even know. It was a very long time. And that takes a toll on me, because we're in an environment that I'm not familiar with, because, like I said, we moved to a different, we're far from family. And even though I have a brother that lives in this state, he's still far drive. So, yeah, when he's gone for a long time, that really takes a toll on me. So that's my least favorite thing. And then he don't have that much freedom. I mean, so far they've been doing great. Anytime we request time off, they've actually granted it. So I really, really, really thank God for that. But it's like, I know it may not last long. So, but yeah, I don't want to jinx it. My favorite thing about being a military wife is all the benefits. We live for free. The apartment is paid for by the military. The lights, the water bill is paid by the military. All we have to do is pay for our internet, car payment, phone bills. So yeah, that is a blessing. And when we're traveling, we get priority. We get to go on the plane first. Yeah, there's little military discounts here and there, but I don't really. Yeah. When we travel, for all the military wives out there, if you're not aware, when you're traveling with your husband, all your bags are free. When you're not traveling with him, your bags are not free. They do not care about us like that, unless we're with our husband or he's active duty. But yeah, that's my favorite and least favorite thing. Somebody said, when is the wedding? So, like I said, my husband and I got married in high school. So, you know, we didn't have the funds to have a big wedding like that. And also, we were trying to sort out our apartment at the time. So, the money had to go towards that. You know, we were both working like not minimum wage, but, you know, we didn't have any degrees or anything to have, you know, those great paying jobs. But we made it through. While we did live in our apartment, I do miss my apartment. It was so luxurious and remodeled and nice compared to this. This have a lot of space, but it's just not up. It need to be remodeled. I mean, I managed to decorate it the best I could, honestly. So the wedding date, I don't have one. I'm going to be honest with you. I'd rather prioritize. So for example, we're gonna buy a house first before we even think about having that extravagant wedding. So that's why I said I wanna be successful. That way I can pay for my big wedding. But it's not on the front of my mind right now, because I'm focused on that house, my education. I don't have a car for myself. I need to purchase a car for myself. I don't need to, but I would like to. it's more convenient, I should say. So there's no wedding date as of yet, but keep waiting on it. God's willing, it will happen. Let's just say that. Next, would you ever collaborate with another YouTuber? Absolutely. Why not? I told you all, I'm a people person. I love socializing. If their content is something that I'm able to do and I'm passionate about, why not? And if your vibe is there, I don't see why not. So, how are you mentally? Mentally, busy. I am busy. Miss, I just have so much to do. I need to focus on enrolling for classes next semester. My anniversary is next week, so I gotta plan an itinerary when we come back. I have to plan his mother's birthday. After that is going to be my best friend is coming to see me, so I need to plan activities for that. Then it's gonna be June. I'm gonna plan activities for my birthday in July. So like, I'm always busy, which I don't mind. Yes, I might complain here and there that I'm tired, but I don't have the time to sit here and be depressed. I don't have the time to be here and sit here and be sad. I don't have time to feel like nothing going for me, because I'm keeping myself busy and interactive. So therefore, I won't have the time to feel like my life isn't doing anything with itself. So yeah, that's where I'm at mentally. Mentally, I'm satisfied. Maybe not satisfied, but mentally, I'm okay. I'm good. I'm good mentally. I'm in a good state right now where I can say, yes, thank you, Lord. You're giving me something to do. So yeah, even if it's just the slightest thing, I'm so grateful for it, because many people don't have the time or energy to do these things and to not feel a certain way, but I do. So I'm forever grateful. How many kids do you want? Two. One boy first and then a girl. But if God would give me the girl first and the boy, that's completely up to him. But if I had a preference, I would like the boy to be first so he can look out for his little sister. That's just my opinion. Okay, three top travel places. So coming in third, this is a hard one. Coming in third is Europe. Anywhere in Europe, Germany, Paris, Italy, Spain. Spain is in Europe? Ooh. Woo, that just took me to geography class. Anyways, anywhere in Europe, number three. Number two, the Maldives. And number one, Bali. Bali, Indonesia. The pressure is getting worse. I love Bali. It's so beautiful. It's so affordable. Not to get there, I should say. But when you get there, it's affordable. Them flights to go to Bali, ain't no joke. And the hours to go to Bali. To go to Bali. But yes, those are my three top destinations. I lied. Oh, this is so hard. Let me tell y'all the places I do want to go. Forget the three top travel places. I want to go to Greece. I want to go to Dubai. I want to go to Europe, like I said. I want to visit all of the Caribbean. All of the Caribbean. I love it. Yeah. Moving on. Favorite designer. Tory Burch. Me love me when I look with Tory Burch. I love Tory Burch. I'm sorry. Like, any slippers? Not any cute slippers. And any cute purse from Tory Burch? Bring it to me. I love it. I love YSL perfume. I love Gucci perfumes. I love Gucci shoes. Louis purses. Chanel bags. And Chanel earrings. Dolce and Gabbana heels and shoes. I'm not a Prada girl. I don't like anything from Prada. I'm telling you that right now. I don't like anything from Prada. I just don't like the designs. It's just not me. Who else I like? I love those little cute pointy Tom Ford heels with the gold heel. But me can't manage. I cannot walk in those, so I'm not buying it. And the YSL heel, the YSL leather heel, cannot manage it. Love it, but cannot manage it. Won't buy it. Moving on. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Wherever God have me. Just the truth. Wherever God have me, I guess I'm not going to end up 5 years. But where I would want to be, I want the house. I want the car. I want a degree. I want the kids. I want the happiness. And I want the businesses to start booming. No, but in 5 years, I have to have my kids. I don't plan on being very old and having my kids. Well, I told my husband I'm not moving house to house, army to army with kids. That's too much work. I want to be settled, content, and I want them to grow up in the house, the dream house that I have in mind, the vision that I have. I want them to be, I want that to be the family home. I don't want to be moving apartment to apartment. That's too much work. And it's going to take a toll on my mental. And I want my mental to stay mentally good. Yeah. So, yeah. How does it feel to be married at a young age? Amazing. I don't regret it. It may not be for everyone. If you think... Let me take off my glasses. If you think you can be in a marriage only on love, you make a sad mistake. You make a sad mistake if you think say you can only love the man or the woman and be in a marriage. Hey! People, marriage take hard work. Marriage take dedication. Marriage take good communication. Marriage take patience. Marriage take God. Why? No, for real. I'm not joking. You may see me there, I laugh and I talk weird, but I'm not joking. To be in a marriage, you have to, him have to love you more than you love him. I'm not telling you no joke. Hey, murder. Not telling no joke. So, I love being married. Because my spouse, I can't speak on everyone's spouse, but my spouse, he's a team player. You know those marriages where you see the woman do everything? Not in this marriage. My husband wash favorite clothes every weekend, and my husband wash up after every time me cook. So if you go, you have to have a team player in the marriage. You can't be doing anything. You can't be the husband and the wife. Am I just roommate? You mad? I'm sorry, let me speak English for my Americans. Your husband should do his part in the marriage. You should not do everything in the marriage. You can't be cook, cleaning, loving him, feeding him, cleaning after him, thinking for him. No, it should be 50-50. And in my marriage, it's 50-50. Yes, we may have arguments here and there, but guess what? We talk it out. We talk it out. And we make a difference. Let me give you an example. Last year, December 2022. Yeah, we're not 2023. Last year, December 2022, my husband told me that I don't give him a chance to talk. And you know what I do? January, I said, baby, go on. I listen in. I said, babe, remember you told me I need to listen more? So go ahead and speak. I'm hearing you. When your spouse tell you that something is, you know, not right and they don't like something, do something about it. That's just how it's gonna work. No lie. So being married at a young age, it's that we're growing together. So we're like this. For me, at least. And then last but not least, the last question, why did you start YouTube? Many reasons. So you know how they have, you know how there's all types of YouTubers on YouTube? Like, for example, Deira Taylor, Christiana Moore, Talitha Jane. Those people, influenced me, and I'm not telling no lie. At first, I didn't watch YouTube like that, like how I'm watching YouTube now. I did not, like, people be like, do you know these YouTubers and stuff like that? This and this happened. I'm like, no, I don't watch YouTube like that. But I started getting into it. And I enjoy it. I really do. The travel vlogs, the fashion vlogs, the day in my life vlogs. I enjoy them. But people have been telling me to start a YouTube channel for 2 years now. They tell me, if you start a YouTube channel, I will subscribe. And I said, you know what? I'm not ready. Mentally, physically, emotionally, I'm not ready to start YouTube. And I told them that, and I was being straight up. And now, here I am. I prayed about it. I manifested it. I did everything. So, here I am. And so far, I'm enjoying it. I'm enjoying giving you guys content. I'm enjoying showing you guys my life. Showing you guys a piece of me, and I'm hoping you all are enjoying my journey with me. It's only gonna get better from here. So if so far you have not loved the content, I still appreciate you liking and subscribing, and I hope that I do show something that you do enjoy in the future. So just bear with me. This is new to me. I don't have all the equipment. You see, I'm using my phone and my iPad. I use my phone to record and I use my iPad to edit. So just bear with me. Things are going to get better from here. Honestly, I thought I couldn't do this. I thought, you know, like, editing is so hard. It is hard. Sometimes it takes me 3 days. It is hard to edit, but I'm willing to do it for you guys, and I'm willing to learn. Like, I'm literally, like, teaching myself as I go. So just bear with me. And I prayed about it, and God didn't say no. So here I am, and I hope that I inspire and encourage someone while I'm on my journey as well. So yes, thank you all for answering all these, not answering. Thank you all for asking all these questions. I really do appreciate it. And I hope I did answer everyone's question. And if there's something that I did not mention, you can type it in the comments and I will say it in my next video or as my videos go along. But I hope you enjoyed knowing a little part of me. And there's so much more to tell, but you know, can I give it all to you in one video? Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you all in my anniversary vlog. And I just love you all so much. Ciao. Miss me with the na 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 na.